Hello, what gives you joy? What gives you joy doing? And can you share it with others? Let it shine. And when you enjoy Jesus, let that joy of faith shine too. Share it. Welcome to you. Jesus said, you are the light of the world. So let your light shine before others, so they may see how you live and give glory to your Father in heaven. Let's pray. Merciful God, you have entrusted many gifts and abilities to every person. We thank you for them. Help us to make good use of them according to your will. To each of us, you have given fruits of your Spirit. To each of us, their own. To none of us, you have given everything. And to no one of us, you have given nothing. Inspire us that we support each other for the well-being of all. Inspire us that we add to each other. So as your church, your followers, we can serve this world. That is our core calling, to be your hands, to be your feet, to be your body in this world. Inspire us, we ask, to become like a city on a hill, like a lamp on a stand, visible and shining light for all around. And we continue to pray in the way Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Across the mission grouping in our area, as is happening all over Scotland, we're working together to develop how we proclaim the gospel, nurture new believers, serve the people in our parishes and beyond, transform unjust societies, protect God's creation, and ensure that our church continues to grow and be relevant today and into the future. To achieve this, we need everyone in our churches to use the gifts that they've been given, and that includes the people who access this service online. This might be in all kinds of different ways, and part of what we're exploring in today's service. And Mark will talk more about how that can work for you online. At the start of his ministry, Jesus probably also had to find out who could do what. And maybe it went a bit like this. Thanks to everyone who so willingly and trustingly took part in this two-part sketch.
Well, everyone, it's great to have you all together. I know you don't all know each other very well, and I'm still getting to know you all too. Making God known to people whose idea of God is quite limited and sharing God's love, that's a huge project, and I'm so glad that you're all going to be part of it. There's loads to do and loads to learn, but first, it would be really helpful to know what your gifts are and where you'd best like to be involved. Peter, you're usually good at talking. Do you want to tell us what your gifts are?
Fishing?
Not always, I think. But I could teach you to fish for people.
I think I prefer fish.
That's not quite what I was meaning. I'll come back to you, Peter. Andrew, I need someone to be ears and eyes. When people are coming around and I'm busy with other things, I need someone who sees that and can bring people to me. Could you do that, Andrew?
What kind of people?
Anyone. After all, you brought your brother. There were some Greeks hanging around the other day. People like that.
But I really don't speak Greek. I'm hopeless at languages.
Martha, you're great in the kitchen. Do you think you could see to the refreshments?
Pigeonholing? Always me in the kitchen? It's not fair. Why not Thomas?
I'm sorry, Martha. And I'm sure we can come up with something else for you too. But have you ever tasted Thomas's brownies?
I'm only joking, Jesus. Of course I can do that. I'll shape up a good team in the kitchen, won't I, Mary?
Zacchaeus, if you and Matthew can take care of the money, that would be great.
Jesus, you can't trust these two collaborators with our finances. They'll sell us to the Romans.
Pipe down, Simon. I think we'll put you in charge of diplomacy. You'll have to learn quite a lot for that.
Yes, Jesus. Whatever you say, Jesus.
Nicodemus, can you take on the night shift? You're pretty much a night owl, as I remember. Now, which of you can accompany our singing? What about you, John Mark? You're always up for a song.
Surely he's much too young for that. He's hardly more than a child. Do you know the music the young ones sing nowadays?
Good for us to learn it. Mary, can you take the minutes?
Which one of us do you mean?
Whichever one is good at taking minutes. I tell you, I'm still getting to know you all, and it's a bit confusing to have so many Marys. It really would be easier if you told me what you're good at rather than the other way round. Okay, I'll just draw lots.
Let's pray. O Jesus Christ, so often we are not quite sure what we shall think of ourselves. We are wavering. At times we are too optimistic about ourselves. At other times we do ourselves down. Jesus, have mercy. Christ, you know us. You are our friend. We are astonished how much you entrust us with, despite our failures. You call us to be light of the world, to shine before others, so other people too may praise God. What a friend you are, Jesus. Amen.
So, Peter on cooking, Mary on welcome duty, Susanna on healing, Thomas on route planning, Bartimaeus in charge of the children, Simon on communication, and Andrew improving his Greek. How does that sound?
But I can't cook.
I can't speak to strangers.
Can't stand the sight of blood. Oh.
Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way to get there?
Okay. As long as they're over 21.
Freedom!
Alpha, beta, gamma, delta, what comes next?
Scrap that then. So why don't you tell me what you're good at? Otherwise, this is doomed from the start.
It's Andrew who's good with the bairns. They just come straight up and speak to him.
And my sister Mary's a really good listener, while her friend Mary is really gifted at massage. Great when you're tired or stressed.
I'll remember that.
And actually, it's Joanna and Susanna who really understand money. Zacchaeus and I just cooked the books.
But Matthew knows how to throw a really good party, and I think you enjoy a good party, Jesus.
You know me well, Susanna.
There's no one like Bartimaeus for reaching out to people. He just has the gift.
Indeed. Bartimaeus, Thomas, Mary, all of you, Susanna, Andrew, oh, and all of you. Will you be part of it? Will you do what you're good at? Will you help spread the kingdom?
We will.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Gladly, Jesus.
Of course.
Yes, Jesus, I will.
If you'll have me.
Yes, please.
I'd love to.
Oh, yes.
I will.
Absolutely.
Count me in, Jesus.
And Martha really does make the best brownies.
If I must.
It's good you're watching, part of our online congregation. If you are in a location far from where we are based, can you add your gifts and talents to a church or gathering of followers where you are? Maybe you already do. Sharing with other followers of Christ locally where you live is a unique joy. Make sure you don't miss out on that. And here online, we love to include, like in this video, your voices, your pictures, your ideas. So just connect with us. Make yourself known. It will be lovely to know who you are. Please also invite others to watch this and other videos. Watch it together. That way you invite them into online worship and can afterwards talk with them about it. Also, click the share and like buttons and write a comment if you can. Your shares, likes and comments make videos like this much more visible to others. Thank you. In our congregations gathered in church this Sunday, we give out a questionnaire, and that is also on our website. Have a look, write on it, and send it if you can. It would be great to hear from you. Thank you.
From Romans chapter 12, Paul writes, "For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourselves more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment, in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you. For just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ we, though many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy in accordance with your faith. If it's serving, then serve. If it's teaching, then teach. If it's to encourage, then give encouragement. If it's giving, then give generously. If it's to lead, do it diligently. If it's to show mercy, do it cheerfully. Love must be sincere. Hate what's evil. Cling to what's good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honour one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervour serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited." Quite often read from the first part of Isaiah chapter 6 about the call of Isaiah and how the flying creatures came to him, touched his lips with burning coals. But we don't often read much beyond that. So this time we're beginning with Isaiah's response and continuing to the end of the chapter. It's from Isaiah 6 verses 8 to 13. Then I heard the Lord say, "Whom shall I send? Who will be your messenger?" I answered, "I will go. Send me." So he told me to go and give the people this message. No matter how much you listen, you will not understand. No matter how much you look, you will not know what is happening. Then he said to me, "Make the minds of these people dull, their ears deaf, their eyes blind, so that they cannot see or hear or understand. If they did, they might turn to me and be healed." I asked, "How long will it be like this, Lord?" He answered, "Until the cities are ruined and empty, until the houses are uninhabited, until the land itself is a desolate wasteland. I will send the people far away and make the whole land desolate. Even if one person out of 10 remains in the land, they too will be destroyed. They will be like the stump of an oak tree that's been cut down." The stump represents a new beginning for God's people.
Complacency is a serious hazard. It has led to congregations being dissolved before now. In the current climate, no church can afford to rest on their laurels. There must be no waiting for things to come our way. The people of today will just not attend a church service just because there is a church. So when any of you hide and hope you don't have to speak of your faith, you bring the end of a congregation closer. A church without people is not a church. A congregation who only congregates but does not go out into this world to serve their Jesus, that congregation has not long left. Harsh words to start with. Though much less harsh than God's message to Isaiah sent as God's messenger, when God predicts the people will not listen, they will not understand, they will not know what's happening. And when Isaiah asks God how long that will be so, God answers, "Until the cities are ruined and empty, until the houses are uninhabited." Even if one person out of 10 remains in the land, that person too will be destroyed and will be like the stump of an oak tree that has been cut down. If people do not hear God's message, if they do not understand God's message, not only churches will turn into ruins, also the whole land. I take no delight in preaching doom like this. It's just not like me. But as I love God's people, I need to be realistic. Being straight with reality, saying it as it is a way to love people. This is a wake-up call of love. There are two likely reactions to this message. I'm not good enough, so I can't. It seems deeply ingrained in the Scottish mentality that we do ourselves down as not good enough. And that is also Isaiah's reply. But Isaiah finds that it is God who empowers Isaiah. God makes Isaiah fit to be God's messenger. And because Isaiah notices he does not have to empower himself, Isaiah's response eventually is, I will go. Send me. The other likely reaction is, I have everything I need in myself. I need no one else. I do not need to be engaged in the body of the kirk. And here the Apostle Paul basically says, how can an eye smell? How can an ear eat? How can an arm run? You need each other. You as a Christian need to pull together with others. You, a vital and gifted part of the church, of Christ's body as it is called. A body will not function if some parts stay apart. The body will die. As at the end of Isaiah's vision, you will be like the stump of an oak tree that has been cut down. Think what that means. Think what a tree stump looks like. You may know one near you, in a garden or beside a road, a stump of a tree cut down. And only then God will do the miracle. The stump represents a new beginning for God's people, is one phrase in the Isaiah. A stump beginning to grow, literally, it says the seed, the new life is contained in the stump. In the dead church is contained the seed of new life. After all that death and cutting down, the core purpose of the church is to be God's messenger in word and deed to today's people. That's who we are called to. Should you be doing yourself down, be assured God will give you what you need. If you think you are enough within yourself, think of being a part of a living body to live. Our faith community needs everyone's gifts engaged.
Let's pray together. God, we notice the vibrancy of your life among us when your people as a community are alive. We need each other. We need people who love us. When we're left alone, we shrink. Help us to discover, name, and appreciate the many gifts and talents our community has been entrusted with. May they be used in ways that make us feel at home in our faith community. God, give the young extra spice in life by the wisdom of the old, and keep the old flexible by the challenges of the young. Help parents to discover new life with their children. May we appreciate, value, and learn from each other. God, to those who are ill, give help by the care of those who are healthy, and those who are healthy grow through the gifts of those who are ill. Enable those who are grieving or downcast to find the trusting space where tears can roll. but help us to make openings for those who've become strangers to faith community. We thank you, God, that you have given so many gifts and talents. When we each contribute them, our community in faith can live once more. So we offer you ourselves, who we are, what we bring. May we live to your glory and share your blessings with one another. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Lord of creation, to you be all praise. Most mighty your working, most wondrous your ways, your glory.
Jesus said, "You are the light of the world. So let your light shine before others, so they may see how you live and give glory to your Father in heaven. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord where you are called, with all that you have. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you in blessing, now and always. Amen."